Hello friends. Whenever we find raised white blood cells, the most common reason is usually infection. Sometimes, infection may not be the obvious cause. And occasionally, for some other reason, you do the blood test and unexpectedly find elevated white cells or leukocytosis. So, what differential diagnosis to consider for leukocytosis? In this video, let's talk about leukocytosis, which is raised white blood cells, and neutrophilia, which is raised neutrophil count. Neutrophilia is an increase of peripheral blood neutrophils, at least 2 standard deviations above the mean. In most clinical laboratories, for adults this corresponds to neutrophils greater than 7,700 per microliter. This is typically seen in patients with leukocytosis, which is more than 11,000 white blood cells per microliter. You must be knowing that normal values for WBC in children vary based on age. Pathophysiology. Neutrophilia may be caused by either increased production or increased emargination of neutrophils. The increased production can be either autonomous or reactive. Coming on to causes. Causes of neutrophilia are many, but the common causes include these. It can be a normal variation in some individuals, or it can be due to infection, acute or chronic inflammation, medications such as glucocorticoids, recombinant granulocyte, or granulocyte monocyte colony stimulating factors, or due to catecholamines. Causes other than infection or medications include asplenia or hypersplenia, myeloproliferative disorders. Leukocytosis can sometimes be found with cigarette smoking, exercise, and various types of physical or emotional stresses. It can also be due to laboratory artifacts or spurious, seen in platelet clumping or cryoglobulinemia. It shall be noted that leukocytosis with values in excess of 50,000 cells per microliter, due to causes other than leukemia, is termed a leukemoid reaction or hyperleukocytosis. Leukemoid reaction may be associated with infections, medications, asplenia, and other conditions. How to evaluate? Urgency of evaluation of neutrophilia is usually guided by patient's clinical condition, the presence of worrisome findings like leukemic blasts on peripheral blood smear, disseminated intravascular coagulation, and the degree and rate of rise of neutrophilia. Initial clinical evaluation of a patient with leukocytosis should obviously include a good history and physical examination. Then, complete blood count with differential and examination of the peripheral blood smear. Peripheral blood smear examination is important to define the nature of the increased neutrophils, identify abnormalities in other cell lineages, and exclude spurious leukocytosis. Other laboratory studies such as nonspecific inflammatory markers, such as C-reactive protein and erythrocyte sedimentation rate, serum chemistries to evaluate associated conditions or complications, and coagulation studies to assess possible disseminated intravascular coagulation, may all be helpful in some patients. Specialized tests, including bone marrow examination, flow cytometry, cytogenetics, and molecular studies may be critical for establishing certain diagnoses, such as chronic myeloid leukemia and acute myeloid leukemia. These specialized tests are not done routinely, but their selection is guided by clinical findings and the differential diagnosis. We won't talk about the treatment of leukocytosis, because it is not a diagnosis. Whenever you come across leukocytosis, explore the reason. And the treatment then is according to the cause. And that's all about leukocytosis in short. Thanks for watching. We hope that you found this video useful. If so, please like and share with colleagues. Subscribe this channel if not already done, to receive latest video notifications.